Welcome to Eleri Sion's Late Show on BBC Radio Wales. And our special guest tonight is you!
Fancy turning into bookworms? Yes, calling bookworms far and wide as it is World Book Day. Tonight's theme, therefore, on The Late Show is songs inspired by books or stories, and your request inspired by reading, please.
I'm headed home, where I know what's going on.
Day, of course, and that's Read My Mind by The Killers. And we've got another one now.
To be. Throw your hands in the air and just do it like me. Put your shoulders out to shake your rump. I got that brand new shit called the hunt. What it's like this and like that, and I'm twisting the sack. Never knew the dog pound was smooth like that. From the top of the mat, from the bottom of the belly, and I like the way you do it. Pluck the shaking your jelly. What your name is, girl? Like the homeboy Nelly, like your homegirl Kelly. Yeah, she do the damn thing. The way she move her hips, got her lips poked out. Then she making a deal. Baby, what's that all about? It's real easy to do. Your homegirl's doing it too. Pay attention to the rules. You can follow it too. It's the huh? What? Get off your butt. Get on the dance floor, baby. Make it jump like this.
Like that.
Like this.
Now
do the huh?
Huh?
What? Like this.
Like that.
Like this.
Now
do the huh?
Huh?
What? Like this.
Like that.
Like this.
Do
the huh,
huh,
what, like this,
like that,
like this,
like
do the huh,
what, she do it like a champ, baby shake that ass, it's too much ass in them pants, what, make me wanna stop, give it all I got, I like it when you're doing that dance, huh, she shaking like a baby rattle, and I'm about to spank baby ass like a paddle, see we can do it any way you want, let's just daddle, they do this dance everywhere, Oakland to Seattle. The first thing you gonna do is take a look around. Like what the fuck you looking at now? Oh, it's me, then you stop popping, drop it down. Like, huh, you know these niggas on you now. And while you doing that, I'ma just straight lean. Like a gangster that I am, crispy and clean. Cause once I stepped on the scene, me and DAZ.
You look like you wanted to sing.
Like, huh,
what? Like this,
like that,
like this.
Now
do the huh,
huh,
what, like this,
like that,
like this.
Now
do the huh,
huh,
what, like this,
like that,
like this.
Now
do the huh,
huh,
what, like this,
like that,
like this.
Huh?
What? So let me ride in, slide in. I'm where it's live at. You wanna get in where you fit in with your five at. Bouncing, loking. You know we smoking. You know we in it to win it. We West Coasting. So here we go again. You know I got to win. Ain't no charge at the door, homie. Slide in and bring your girl too. She brought the whole crew. She got it popping, she dropping, she keep it all true.
Thinking I'm gonna make it rain. Wait a minute, babe. You gotta show me something before I do a damn thing. I'ma let you nizzo, D-O-double-jizzo, B-O-U-N-D, gangsters all up on the flizzo. I came to watch you work your body, I'm Young Gotti, I'm the bomb legend like John Gotti, I'm in the party. Now what you wanna dizzo, you and your zoo, drop it like you own it, baby, huh?
What? Like this,
like that,
like this,
now do the huh,
huh,
what,
like this,
like that,
like this,
now
do the huh,
huh,
what, like this.
Like that,
like this,
now
do the huh,
huh,
what, like this,
like that,
like this,
huh,
huh,
what,
what.
Taylor Swift and Love Story. And lots of you are getting in touch with us already with your song requests then. with Book Day, World Book Day, as the inspiration. Matthew Gilbert, he's got a nice one. We may have a little chat with him shortly now to have a little update on Mam. Malcolm Williams has gone for Goldfinger by Shirley Bassey. The Wonky Donkey. No, we are not doing that one. We nearly got into a bit of bother with the words of that song earlier this week, as chosen by Gabe. And Paul Anka and Diana. Oh, we might play that one for you, Malcolm, in Bridgend. Pauline Davis would love For Whom the Bell Tolls by Metallica. Now then, every single one of these song requests are connected with a book, a story, or an adaptation. So keep them coming in on 03 700 100 110. You can text us on 81012. You can email us lateshow@bbc.co.uk. And also, let us know what you're reading at the moment, or share the book that made a lasting impression on you, or perhaps changed your life. Or what's your favourite book of all time, one that you can't help keeping, or one that you can't help going back to? I'd love to hear from you this evening. Also, of course, we've got Guess What Happened quiz coming up. We are going to be chatting to Sir George from Chester. But a twist this evening, and you'll find out exactly what the twist is at 11 o'clock. But let's get back to your song choices then. And this one with a connection, of course, with books. And we have gone for the Beatles, because this was inspired by Lewis Carroll's Alice Through the Looking Glass. A lot of words there I could have tripped over, you see, hence my very monosyllabic delivery. Okay, the Beatles, and of course I Am the Walrus. You are listening to The Late Show here on BBC Radio Wales on World Book Day. Thanks for tuning in.
Yeah, what's up, man? I need to get hold of some big. Yeah, what's up, man? I need to get a key.
I know we can get an LP.
LP, man, if you went crazy, man, I'm talking about some. Man, I need to get it right now, man. Why don't you hook me up with a 5-0?
I can hook you up with a 12-inch.
12-inch, man, you done went crazy. You don't even know what time it is. Out here on the streets and don't know what time it is, man. You's a fool.
Yo, homeboy, you a fool. You don't know what time it is out here messing up your mind. You know what I'm saying? This is Ice-T talking to you, boy. I'ma tell you what time it is. Yo, it's time for me to pump off the volume. No problem, the record's revolving. Evil's the mixer, I'm the rap trickster. Paparazzi's on the bum rush for pictures. Ice, cooling yo colder than ever. Punk executioner, he pulls the lever. Rotate the wax, then cut and axe the tracks. Push up the levels till the red lights max. Don't try to size up, you better wise up to the rap criminals. We're on the rise up. We're selling until we succeeded. Dope beats and lyrics, no beepers needed for this deal. I'm the big wheel. I'm selling you, don't smoke your feel. Out on the dance floor, on my world tour. I'm selling in each and every record store. I'm the kingpin when the wax spins. A smack or take you to a show end. You don't need it, just throw that stuff away. You wanna get it, let the record play.
Oh man, I like this beer, man. It's feeling alright, boy. What'd you say your name? was, man.
Loving this, this is coming out your speakers. Bass through the bottoms, highs through the tweeters. But this bass, you don't need a pipe, just a tempo to keep you hype. Grooving like I see you doing. So stupid crap would just ruin your natural high. Why, that ain't fly, and anyone who says it is lies. Move like I knew you would, like I knew you could. And if you ain't cracked out, then I know you should be able to give me a clap to match exact with the tracker. Since I know you ain't, I expect that. Oh, now this jam is lit, it's like the ultimate. People but still physically fit. I make $1 million, pack my dough in trucks from selling dope beat, dope rhymes, dope cuts. I'll be the biggest dealer in history, cause all the fly will be that. Bring it to boil, evilly rock it up. You want in? I don't think you got enough. Last suckers cross, syndicate shot them up. Cops found them in the lake, bottom up. I don't play when it comes to my. I check my lyrics close, like with a microscope. I don't clean them up with no Ivory soap. I leave them hard and pure, hope that you can cope. Cause you might, if you overdrive. This record tape a CD, because the sound I created on this wax is like a chemical. And the knowledge I give makes me invincible.
Oh, Mr. Man, I'm loving you, man. You got it going on, man. What else you got?
I got some of that Kumo D.
Oh, yeah, man. I want some of that, man.
Got some Dougie Fresh.
Oh, give me an ounce of that, man. I want that all night long.
Got some Eric B and Rakim.
Oh, that is some real deal right there.
Got some of that LL Cool J.
Nah, man. I don't want none of that, man. You keep that, man.
Got some Boogie Down Productions, KRS-One.
Oh, now you're talking, man. Come on.
Public Enemy.
Yeah, don't stop, don't stop.
Biz Markie.
Make the music
I'm
with
your mama.
Cops just don't know what to do, because my breaks through no matter what they do. My stuff gets to you, kicking on the boulevard. My tempo's hyped and hard, I don't ask, the ice just Bogart. Sire Records puts me out with Warner Brothers clout. My hits the street with no doubt. Evilly adds the cut, then removes it. Is checks for purity, and then approves it. And then you get it, try it, and like it. And if it ain't potent, we remix it and spike it to bring it to pure. Not a noose in the rope, cause if you're doing, you're on death row. You're just a toy punk, then mess with that junk. You want some real, come look in my trunk. Selling is life, 100% legit. So get real, fool, and try some real hit.
Word up, my brother, you got me as a kite. I feel good tonight. Ice-T, man, you all right.
Drama. Pluto TV understands they have tons of dramas. Why are they moving that airbag? It's to make the point that with Pluto TV there is no catch. It's always free. Thousands of TV shows and movies, nothing to pay. Can we get the airbag back now? That was dramatic, right?
Yeah.
Stream now, pay never. Pluto TV.
She's at home.
grooving, keep the music strong. Oh.
Barry White, and let the music play. Oh, welcome, ladies and gents, and all you night owls. I'll be there now in a moment. To the Friday Eve show here on The Late Show. And oh my gosh, you are loving the theme this evening. You are non-stop with your beautiful song requests, and they are beautiful. Hopefully we're going to be able to squeeze every single one between now and 12:30, which means every single track, hopefully, apart from that one by Barry White, will be a song-related track to the theme. But, of course, we need to chat with you. Oh, we've got a first caller in for the night. Who's there, Gabe? Evening,
well,
lovely.
I tell you what, nobody's going in the parlour tonight. We're going straight into the library, if that's all right with you.
Yes, great shout.
Okay,
and
we've got
quiet.
I've pushed in all these high back chairs.
Mm. Oh, gosh.
And what do you think? I'm wearing my Noel Coward smoking jacket as well.
Oh. You're breaking all the rules.
I know. I'm
you
not smoking. Are. I'm just.
You're such a rebel.
But look, feel the quality on this. Oh,
okay.
Oh, it's silky.
Very nice.
Oh,
it's very
fabulous.
Sumptuous.
Oh,
yes.
I thought you'd like it. Anyway, oh, enough. Let's get on with it. We've got Matthew Gilbert here.
Oh, sorry, Matthew. Oh. I can't
Hello.
Stop stroking Gabe at the moment.
Oh, please. Oh.
Behave yourself.
Oh, it's wonderful. Oh,
well,
I'm going.
This is
bye.
When he turns up in quality gear, you know, I can't help myself. It's a change from the Hawaiian shirts.
I bet he looks gorgeous, doesn't he?
Oh, he is looking dashing, as per usual. But what about you, Matthew Gilbert? Are you in your smoking jacket this evening? Are you a bit of a reader, actually, Matthew? Are you?
Not really, no. I don't read much. No.
Mm. Do you not have time, probably, do you? Because you're so busy.
It's just I do read sometimes, but not all the time. And
okay,
I kind
well,
of
well,
have the mum a lot.
Yeah, of course. What can, before we speak about your lovely mum, what was the last book that you think, if you can remember, what was it? Or what's your favourite book that you've read over the years?
Which Harry one? Potter.
Oh, you're a Harry Potter fan.
Oh, yes, a massive Harry Potter, yes.
Oh, my gosh. Well, those books will keep you entertained for the rest of your life. There's so many of them, are they?
Definitely. And do you know what I've been reading recently when I've gone to bed? The one I got from Victoria Bookshop, the Jamie Roberts one. It's really good, that one I've been reading.
What, Jamie Roberts, the rugby player?
Yeah, he was in, a while ago, he was in Victoria Bookshop in Halford West, and I walked past from him. I said, there's Jamie Roberts in there. And I went in and I had my autograph done with him, and he signed a book for me as well.
So is it his autobiography? What is it?
It is, yes, yeah.
Oh, how fab. Oh, that's one
it's
for the
amazing.
List then. It's amazing. Oh, why do you enjoy it so much? Is he very truthful in it?
He is, yes.
Okay, all right.
Yeah.
Well, okay, good.
You know Gabe looks lovely tonight in his, library stuff. Whoever's on the buttons, do they look nice as well?
Well, she could have combed her hair, but apart from that, yes, she looks lovely. She actually looks lush, and she told me to say that.
Who was that, Llinos?
Llinos, the delectable Llinos. She told me to say that.
She's a wonderful human being, Llinos.
Oh, she is. She is a wonderful human being. And now she says, yes, you're right, Matthew, you're bang on. why don't you just go out for coffee together, guys, instead of me being the mediator here or the connection? And I can pay. Yes, okay, she said that as well. Can we move on, please, Matthew Gilbert? Let's move on.
Yes.
Your mum, okay. How is she?
We went to the doctor's yesterday and we had the results. Everything's come back clear, but they can't work out why she's still unwell. So they put her on some medication now, which seems to be helping. She's got to go up then next Friday for an ECG. In the surgery, and then we got to wait for a letter to come through where she's got to have jelly on the belly in the hospital.
Oh, bless her. Yeah, so she's going to have a little scan.
And they said as well, the doctor thinks she might have a slight heart murmur.
Oh, no.
Yeah,
okay.
That's what they think, yeah.
But they can control that, if that's the issue.
They can
control that, so don't worry about that, tell her.
No.
Okay, it's so hard.
It is, and she keeps saying sorry, saying that, I'm a burden and all this. I said, I wouldn't be here looking after you if I didn't want to.
Exactly. Oh, you are such a good son, you know.
Exactly.
You are such
She'd
a darling.
She'd be lost around me.
She would.
And
oh,
I'm even taking her out to cheer her up tomorrow, so...
Ooh, where are you going tomorrow?
Wetherspoons.
Oh, crikey Moses. 11 o'clock? Oh, no, they open early for breakfast, don't they? What time are you
going
to take her then?
We're going down about 11 o'clock. We can't order food out till 11:30, so...
Oh, right.
So she's going to have a... She said she might have a shandy tomorrow, so
I
don't mind.
No.
Yeah.
Oh, a little shandy on a Saturday morning. A Friday morning, I mean.
Friday,
well, remember to be back in the house by 2 o'clock, because I'm on at 2 with the afternoon show, okay?
I always listen in on a Friday. Always. During the day goes by that I don't miss you.
Oh.
And when you've done Carol Vorderman's show, you've done an amazing job then.
Well, I'm back doing that on Saturday again.
Oh, wicked. I'll have to listen in again.
Oh, fantastic. Well, at least I know one person's listening. That's fab. Oh, thank you, Matthew.
Somebody from the late show's got to listen in, eh?
Yeah, somebody's got to do it.
Yeah.
And, you know, I think, you know, apart from, you know, looking after your mum, looking after yourself, there's only one little additional job that you've got to do. And then I won't be there on a Saturday for a while, so you can just, you know... Do whatever you
I might
to
watch
do.
The darts after I've watched you all weekend, then.
The what?
The darts from Minehead.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah, it's on the telly tomorrow from Minehead, so I'll be watching all of that.
Okay, can I suggest something else for you?
Certainly.
BBC iPlayer. Okay? Yeah. You can catch up on this. If you like modern Westerns, which are Westerns made today, not made back in the 1950s, 60s, 70s, 80s, right?
Yeah.
It's called The Englishman. No, it's called The English. Let me get it right. It's called The English. All right. It's got the fantastic Emily Blunt in it. And she's a British lady who goes out, okay? And I'm not going to say too much, but she's had a huge, huge grief in her life. And I think she's on a journey of revenge, all right?
Oh, that sounds good. I'll have to watch that.
And she befriends an Indian man and two cultures so different, all right? Because she's obviously white, he's Indian. But they become a close unit. And I'm not going to say more than that as well.
Oh.
All right? So it could be a love story. It could be not a love story. Because I'm on episode 6, which is the last episode. And oh my gosh, I'm enjoying it.
And you're on the Simba next week, aren't you, as well?
Yeah, I think so. Or the following week, I'm not sure. But I'll let you know once I know, okay, darling? Right, then, Matthew, sweetheart, you can't keep complimenting me all the time. But
why?
I love it. No, I love it. Matthew, my sweetheart, why don't you choose a song on tonight's theme and please send us all, or send Angela all our love from all of us here on the Late Show, will you?
And can I also send my love to Gabe's mum as well, who's poorly? Me and mum thinking of her too.
Oh.
And I'm going to send her a virtual touch as well, if I can.
And can I just say as well that Mrs. Christmas has just got in touch. Hi all, how about Matthew and I do a darts match for charity around Christmas time? Because this needs to be a virtual one that works on radio. Are you up for that?
100%.
Fabulous! It's something for us to look forward to. Okay, what would you like us to play for you?
Well, I'd like you to dedicate it to the wonderful Mrs. Christmas, Janie Caswell, Jean Amslow, and my mate that's on at 11, George. It's Romeo and Juliet by Dire Straits.
Perfect choice. Love this one. Matthew, you take care. Have a lovely time tomorrow.
As soon as I've got any more updates, I will keep you informed.
Thank you, sweetheart.
You're welcome.
And hope she enjoys that shandy. Thank you, sweetheart. Ta-ra.
Bye-bye.
Oh, here's Dire Straits then. Shakespeare. Angela, of course, she was listening in Pembroke Dock. And obviously, we will make sure that we bring you all the updates on how she's doing and hope she'll be doing better once she's obviously had a bit of a run on the medication. Okay, Jingle Mel has been in touch. I absolutely love this film with David Bowie. I'd love to hear Never Ending Story. So- Obviously looking better than Orville, and he wasn't wearing a nappy. But I've looked on a recent track, and on this, face picture maybe. What I'm doing, I'm Googling and talking at the same time, not very good at multitasking me. And he's still got that little spiky look about him, but not as spiky. Actually, it does look a little bit like my toilet brush, if it was white. That's all I'm saying. Check him out. Okay, do we want to play Guess What Happened? We will get back to your song requests, of course, connected to World Book Day. If you're still thinking, well, you're very welcome to get in touch with us. I'll give you the contact details shortly. But let's play Guess What Happened, okay? So what happens here? Well, we give you a date, we give you a location, and we give you a cryptic clue. So tonight, I'm going to say 1989. All right? So whatever happened, it happened in 1989. And there's a connection with this song and that date, or this event, I should say. This is Nina. What happened in our little quiz this evening? It happened in 1989, and lo and behold, yes, indeed, you've guessed it. It happened in Germany, where Nina is from. Nothing to do with hairy armpits. I want to, you know, take you off that little journey straight away. Okay, so 1989, Germany. Any ideas? If you think you know the answer, 03 700 100 110 or text 81012, or you can email lateshow@bbc.co.uk. And this has a little connection with the particular event. Here's the Style Council. I'm not going to mention the title, it's too obvious.
You don't have to take this crap. You don't have to sit back and relax.
You can actually try changing it.
I know we've always been taught to rely upon rules and authority, but you never know until you try how fears just might be. Competition is a color TV. We're on some pawns with a video machine.
Keep your slaves to BHP.
Until our unity is threatened by those who have and who have not, those who are with but those who are without, and dangle jumps like a donkey's carrot.
Come tumbling down. So it happened in 1989. It happened in Germany. What do you reckon? What do you think? Well, the clue is bricks. I wonder what happened. 1989, Germany, bricks. 03700 100 110. Text 81012. You know what to do. Do get in touch.
Standing there alone. Top of the line, all the time, now we're
brothers, other rappers who get all the credit. But now I got a rhyme and it's more than couple steady. Cause if on TV in the New York Times, then the Guinness Book of Records for the most damn rhymes.
We might be young, it doesn't really matter. I'll be 10 rhymes, we'll make the speakers shatter. And then you'll hear us throughout the nation. The hip hop boys.
Chinos, what is the connection? Deutschland 89. Okay, it's all there in that song. So what happened in Deutschland 1989? And the clue is brick. 03 700 100 110. Text 81012 or email lateshow@bbc.co.uk. Wonderful. We will sort it out at 11:30. If that's okay with you. And Sir George is joining us shortly after this one. is going to be related to World Book Day, because there has been a massive flurry of song requests this evening. And don't you worry, we've got every single one of them. Okay, we've got it covered, like the book. So you're listening to The Late Show here on BBC Radio Wales. Lovely to have you with us. And we are here Monday to Thursday night from 10 o'clock till 12:30. And remember, Friday night, every Friday's here on Radio Wales as well, if you want a little disco in your kitchenette. But on a Thursday night, what do we do? Well, we do this.
All
it's
day.
Georgie time.
All night.
All night.
All day.
All day.
Oh my goodness me. Here he is, my knight in shining armour. If you had a horse, a big stallion now, I'd stick you on it and we'd ride away into the sunset together. How are you?
Well, a bit disappointed tonight.
Disappointed? Why?
Because I got no Wi-Fi on the black iPad and no Wi-Fi on the mobile.
Which means?
Which means I can't do the quiz tonight, unfortunately.
Oh my gosh. You know my fast intake of breath there? That's what everybody across Wales has just done now.
Yeah.
But don't worry. Oh. Don't worry. Right, think on your feet, Eleri. Think on your feet. What are we going to do? Well, if you don't have questions for me, why don't I grab some questions for you?
Yeah, that'd be fine. Can I ask how you are first?
Yes, I'm fine. Yes. You know what?
And while I've got the opportunity, I'd like to say a few hi to a few of my fans.
Come on, then.
I'd first of all like to start with Matthew Gilbert and his mum. Hey, Matthew and your mum. Oh, let's have a cheer for them, please.
You know, can we have a cheer? Okay, next.
Who's on the button, darling?
It's Llinos. She's looking delectable and lush, apparently.
She's going to sort her out next week.
In what way, Sir George? How are you going to sort her out next week?
Oh, I don't know. I'll think about it.
All right, okay. All right, so you've said hello to the lovely Matthew and glorious Ange. Who else?
The next one, of course, I'd like to say hello to one of my best friends in Virginia, that is Sir Joseph Short.
As another cheer for Sir Joseph.
And I said to this one, Peggy, I love you, oh Peggy, my Peggy Sue.
Oh, lovely Peggy. Oh, well, Peggy's having a few mentions tonight, isn't she? Lots of love to Peggy Sue. And anybody else?
Well, actually, there's a friend who I haven't said hello to for ages and ages and ages. And that is Carol Rees-Jones.
Carol Rees-Jones. Well, that's a lovely group of people that you've just mentioned there. Can I just mention a couple as well? Beth in Ystradgynlais would like to say hello to you this evening and sending all her best to you. And Delboy in Dorset. And also, I'm seeing Sue in Penclawdd. She's just literally emailed in and she says, can you please say hello to Sir George? She says this every week, because you're so glorious, and Linda Thomas in Bryn Mawr. Okay, so that's it. We've had our little love-in, but I think it's time now for me to go and...
When I was doing your... the lovely Van Gogh.
Diamond Art?
Yeah. Yes. I've been thinking that as a very special thank you to you, I would like to know what breed your dog is.
Oh, my little dog. And he's lying beside. My little Ralphie is lying by my side this evening. You should see him. He's like an acrobat.
Hello, Ralphie.
Oh, don't. He's sleeping. He has been snoring and dreaming. He's been doing these sounds, okay? All right, listen to this, Sir George. He's been doing this. Oh, and I've just woken him up. He's probably thinking, why is she making that stupid... No, it's not your fault. I'm making the silly noises here. Anyway, yes, he is a... he's a Shishon, but he's a cross between a Bichon Frise and a Shih Tzu.
A Shih Tzu, right.
Yes, more Shih Tzu than anything else.
Because what I'm going to do for you as a special thank you for getting me a Van Gogh picture to work on. And it's coming along nicely. That next week, if I got live by that, I'll send the progress of it.
Fabulous. I look forward to that.
But I'm going to do for you at some point this year a very special picture of your, or for you to have of your dog.
Oh, that's
because
so
you have been
sweet.
So kind to me.
Oh, Sir George.
I don't mind you knowing about it.
Sir George, it's so easy to be kind to you because you're absolutely lovely. And the listeners are waiting. They're waiting to see how well you're going to do in this quiz. Should we do
all
it?
Right.
Okay,
I'll
then.
I'll let you ask me questions then.
Yes,
tonight.
Yes. But I'm going to rustle some up now very quickly, okay? But in the meantime, Andy and Robin Blackwood have been in touch. Hello, Eleri. Could you please play That's What Friends...
I want to be a partner, can't you see? The music is just starting, night is calling, and I am falling. Dance with me. Fantasy could never be so killing, I feel free. I hope that you are willing, pick the beat up and kick your feet.
BBC Radio Wales. And what time is it?
It's time for the chaser from Chester, Sir George.
Right then, ladies and gentlemen, this evening we are turning the tables because Sir George from Chester tonight is going to become the answerer and I become the quiz master. I apologise if I don't do such a brilliant job as Sir George does, but I will try my very best. So, Sir George, are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
Right. The quiz has a bit of a theme, and a theme that I believe that you will enjoy, something to do with a doctor.
All right.
Okay.
That's okay.
Fine. Question number one. The doctor, as in Doctor Who, the doctor has two hearts. True or false?
True.
Correct!
Two.
All right, two.
25.
25. There you go. Now you're going to have a call.
Old Man Nature?
No. Another call.
Okay, number two.
All right, two.
Twenty-five.
There you go.
Now... emptying that. Okay, one out of one. Next. Question number two, Sir George. The name of the 10th Doctor is... any idea? I do have a choice of names. The name...
could you give me the choice of names, please?
Of course I can. The name of the 10th Doctor is... A. Matt Smith. B. Christopher Eccleston. C. David Tennant. Or D. Peter Capaldi. The name of the 10th Doctor, please, Sir George.
I think it was David Tennant.
Yes.
That was a guess.
What do you mean it's a guess? You are an aficionado on Doctor Who. Right, okay, don't say it's guessing. Just pretend that you know. Okay, that's two out of two. You are nearly halfway. Question number three.
Right.
Who is the Lord and Creator of the Daleks? Who is the Lord and Creator of the Daleks?
The answer to that one is Davros.
Are you sure?
Yes. Spence.
Spence. Three out of three. Right. Wonderful. Wonderful going. Next question. Question number four. The colour of the TARDIS is...
blue.
It doesn't add...
four... out of four. Sir George, how are you feeling?
All right.
Okay. Not nervous?
No. Totally relaxed.
You are making me look like an absolute idiot. You do realise this because I've been doing these quizzes on a Thursday night for 2 years and really, really have I had six out of six. And tonight, you are... absolutely thrashing it. Okay, question number five.
Right.
The Daleks can fly. True or false?
Well, that's true.
In the works, or a sonic screwdriver. Okay. I know you love a bit of Mary Poppins. I know you love the film. So my final question for 6 out of 6, 100%.
Right.
I need the correct answer to this question. Which wind carries Mary Poppins to the Banks family?
And I've got the answer to that is the west wind.
Wait. Think. I'm going to give you a choice. I'm going to give you a choice, all right?
Yeah.
Is it A, the east wind? Is it B, the west wind? Is it C, the north wind? Or is it D, the south wind? And remember, the wind is coming in from the east here in Britain tomorrow.
I think it's the west wind.
Right, can you just hold the line? I'm just going to inquire. A referee, I've got a referee. Could you just stay where you are at a moment, please? Okay then.
No, there's no R. Rita.
Come, Carries.
Are you asking me?
No, I'm asking Google.
Oh, right.
Shh. To the... just talk amongst yourselves, ladies and gentlemen, and I will be with you shortly. If I could type, obviously, I'd come in. Now then, are you sure? Are you certain? Are you absolutely 100%?
Absolutely positive.
I'm giving you a chance to change your answer very quickly.
All right, go for east wind then.
I'm giving you a chance to change your answer very quickly.
All right, go for east wind then.
Are you sure? East wind, is that your final answer? Yes, okay, let's go for east wind. Are you correct?
Congratulations.
Obviously, you came to your senses in the end. And now then, Gabe, do we have a bonus question?
We do, but before that, although the Mary Poppins, the magical English nanny, blows in on the east wind, there was a song called West Wing, which was deleted from the movie. And it was a short ballad to be sung by Mary.
Okay. Well.
There we go. That's a bit of useless information, but because your question was centred around Doctor Who and space and that, we've actually got a space-themed bonus question that was sent in by Drew from Penarth, and he wanted to know how many flags were currently planted on the moon.
Oh, my gosh. Right, then. How many? Is this for Sir George or both Sir George and myself?
No, this is just for you.
Okay, how many flags? Oh, can you help me out here, Sir George? Come on, don't you laugh there. That evil laugh.
How many flags were planted on the moon?
And what do these flags represent, then?
What would they represent? They would represent your country.
I have no idea. What a silly...
Currently, 6 flags planted on the moon. And these were planted by the USA. They were with Apollo 11, 12... 14, 15, 16 and 17. But the first one, Apollo 11, apparently it was blown over by the exhaust by the lunar module as it took off from the moon's surface. The added, you know, I could have given you 7 if you'd said that. Because
please, I'm dropping off here.
Because China has its own lunar exploration program, and they had a robotic lander that unfurled a flag, but it wasn't planted by humans.
Oh my gosh, I need to actually play a banger of a song to get people back listening.
Yeah.
Drew, can I give him a massive, massive non-round of applause for that question? Oh gosh, give me a chance for goodness sake. All right.
Boy, it's funny how you need the momentum.
Extremely clever one tonight is Sir George from Chester. Absolutely 100%, 6 out of 6. You are a hero, and I'd love to play a song for you. What do you want me to play for you, darling?
Did you manage to find the one I wanted, Dave?
Well, we've got a certain Mr. Needs lined up for you. Not the one that you wanted, but the one that refers and reflects who he is. This is I Am What I Am by Mr. Chris Needs.